Now it is time for our first real inference test. We're going to learn to use a one-sample z-test for hypothesis testing. The one-sample z-test is a parametric procedure. It tests whether a sample mean is statistically significantly different than the population mean when the standard deviation of the population, or sigma, is known. In order to use a one-sample z-test, you need one continuous or scale-dependent variable, a population mean, and a population standard deviation. This test cannot be done in SPSS with drop-down menus, although I have a video showing how to use SPSS syntax to do it. Now, you may recall an example about polar bears, in which we determined that the average polar bear walks 100 miles or 100 kilometers per week. That is our population value. If we knew the standard deviation for that population, we could compare a sample of polar bears drawn from that population who drink caffeine to see if their mean of 150 is statistically significantly different than the population mean of 100. Let's examine the research design for a one-sample z-test. I am going to use this example to illustrate the subtle differences in research design for all of the tests we will learn. My hope is that you will see how research design relates to the choice of a test and begin to understand when to choose what statistical test. The research question will always be the same. Is recall better under hypnosis or without hypnosis? With each new test, you will see how the research design changes. So to do a z-test, we're going to begin with an existing memory test that has been standardized on non-hypnotized people. This memory test has a mean and a standard deviation, and those values apply to the population. All human beings will score an average on this test with a standard deviation. Of course, this is not realistic because not all human beings in the world have taken this test. But we will revisit this idea later. We never actually know the standard deviation of the population. But let's go back to our research design. What would be our independent variable? The independent variable would be our one sample of people whom we hypnotized and then give them the memory test. What would be the dependent variable? The DV is the number of words recalled on the memory test. How many words did each hypnotized person get correct? Comparing the sample mean of our hypnotized sample to the mean and standard deviation of the test, which represents a population, would allow us to answer the question, do hypnotized participants remember more words than unhypnotized population? No test here, just an example. I'm going to use a different example to illustrate how to conduct a one-sample z-test. For this example, I'm going to use some data that I found on the internet about the internet. It concerns this bar chart about the average age of users on social networks and online communities. With the increase in social networking usage, researchers are interested in patterns of usage, especially in the age of users. Research found that the average age of social network users in the United States is mu equals 36.9 years old. Our population is all social networking users. Our sample is a randomly selected group of social networking users from the website LinkedIn. Is the average age of users on this website statistically significantly different than the average age of the population of social networking users, a population that has a mean of 36.9 years? To use the z-test, we're going to need some more information. Notably, we need to know the standard deviation of the population. The background to our research is this. Researchers at the website Pingdom calculated the average age of users of social media websites and found that the average age of social networking users is mu equals 36.9 and sigma, standard deviation, equals 10. Now here I need to add that I made up that standard deviation. Almost never do we know the true standard deviation of the population. In case you're interested, however, my best estimate of the true standard deviation of the population, at least based on these data, would be about 3.72 years. Well, continuing. This distribution is approximately normal. You obtain a sample of 25 users of the social networking site LinkedIn. The mean age for this sample is 44.2 years old. Is the average age of your sample of LinkedIn users different from the U.S. population of social networking users? And about that sample size, I've said that an N of 30 is a minimum, but I chose the N of 25 for ease of calculation. Sometimes I will simplify for the sake of teaching concepts, and you'll see why that 25 is useful when we do a square root. So, our research question is the average age of the sample of LinkedIn users different from the U.S. population of social networking users? On every slide, I will include the mean, standard deviation, sample size, and sample mean so that you will have them readily available as we do the math. First, is this a directional or a non-directional research question? In this case, the question is whether LinkedIn users are different. Simply being different does not indicate the direction, higher or lower. This is a non-directional hypothesis, so we will use a two-tailed test. Let's work through the five steps of hypothesis testing using this example. Step number one, select the appropriate statistic. In this case, we are comparing a single sample with a mean of 44.2 to a population value of 36.9 with a standard deviation of 10. So we will be using the one sample z-test. Remember that in a statistics class, step one will always be the easiest. The answer to the appropriate statistic is whatever test we are learning this week. In the real world, however, choosing the correct test is very important and sometimes difficult. As you gain experience, you will learn to read your data to determine what kind of test could be used to analyze them. Step 2. State the null and alternative hypothesis. In this case, we are doing a two-tailed test, so we'll start with the null hypothesis. In words, we might say, the sample of LinkedIn users is no different than the population of average users. In symbols, that would be H sub 0 colon mu equals 36.9. In other words, the sample is drawn from a population with a mean of 36.9. For the two-tailed alternative hypothesis, in words, we might say the sample of LinkedIn users is different than the population of average users. In symbols, this would be H sub 1 colon mu does not equal 36.9. Now just for practice, let's write a one-tail alternative hypothesis, even though we're not going to use it in this case. In words, we would say the sample of LinkedIn users is older than the population of average users. In symbols, that would be H sub 2 colon mu is greater than 36.9. Literally, that means that the sample of LinkedIn users is drawn from a population that has a mean greater than 36.9. For the future, when you are writing the null and alternative hypotheses, follow this one weird old trick. When you're doing a two-tailed test, start by writing the null hypothesis. When you're doing a one-tailed test, start by writing the alternative hypothesis. So step three is to select a level of significance. To calculate the critical value, we need to know whether we are using a one or two-tailed test and at what alpha value. We have already established that we will be using a two-tailed test. For most research, the level of significance will be alpha equals 0.05. Technically, you could set the alpha level to any value your heart desired. But for scientific research, you really only have two choices, alpha equals 0.05 and alpha equals 0.01. unless the problem says otherwise, assume the value is alpha equals 0.05, two-tailed test. Finding the critical value for a z-test is easy. You only have two options. If you're using a two-tailed test at alpha equals 0.05, your critical value for a z-test will always be positive or negative 1.96. If you're using a one-tailed test, your critical value for a z-test will always be either positive 1.645 or negative 1.645. Choose the positive 1.645 if you are doing a one-tailed test to the right, larger than, greater than, and choose the negative 1.645 if you're doing a one-tailed test to the left, smaller than or less than. Because the z-test uses a normal curve, you do not need degrees of freedom. In the next video, I will show you how to calculate and write up a one-sample z-test by hand.